So the English title is I'm Thinking of Ending Things. And the book is about a young couple who have been dating for not a very long time. And they are, as the book starts, they're setting out on a road trip together for the first time. And the girlfriend in the relationship is feeling guilty about agreeing to go because she's having doubts of the relationship. She likes her boyfriend a lot. He's very smart. But she's thinking that maybe the relationship has run its course. And so that's how they start off together. And then I would say the book takes a fairly ominous turn about halfway through when they reach their first destination. And it's, I don't know, it's a book for me that's about relationships and solitude and reality. Ideas that I sort of first came across when I was studying philosophy, and I wanted to write about them. And my first instinct was to write about them in an academic way, but that would have been very boring, and no one would have wanted to read it other than, you know, philosophers. So I had an idea for a story about this couple, and I started to write it. So yeah, I think it is. I think it is a bit of a love story. And, you know, I'm interested. I sort of think of it as just a novel. And I like hearing how others interpret it. So yes, some people call it a thriller. Some people call it a horror novel. Some people call it a, you know, philosophical suspense. And all of those things are fine. But I think you're right that there is elements of a love story. And a relationship is at the heart of what this is about. And I think the couple in this story are, you know, talking about things. They're thinking about things. And it's, you know, I wonder myself, how well do we ever get to know people? Even people that we're close with, people that we're married to. You know, our inner world is always distinct from the world while we are existing with others, and our actions don't always align with our thoughts. And so I think that is also, you know, a theme of the book. I mean, both. One book that I read probably 10 years ago now, and I remember finishing it and then immediately starting it again. And it's a book called Under the Skin, by a writer named Michelle Faber, which also became a movie. So it actually applies for both film and books. But it's a wonderful book, and what I really liked about it was that it sort of was very difficult to describe as far as genre or what type of book. Some people called it science fiction, some people called it thriller or horror. But like for me, again, it was just a novel, and it was a novel unlike anything I'd read before. And I love the feeling of wanting to start it again. And I love rereading books. So I thought about that when I was writing this book, that I wanted to make it short. I wanted to take a lot of the stuff out of the book and leave only the essence of the story. And that way, if people got to the end, maybe they would want to start it over again. And maybe they could read it in one or two sittings. And that was sort of my hope. So, and then, of course, there's, you know, many, many films that have influenced me as well. And a lot of the Hitchcock movies. And so for me, it's I feel like inspiration comes from everything. It comes from reading and watching things. But it also just comes from my experience as a person and interacting with people and observing people and talking to friends. And so I'm sort of, I always try to be open to the world and what, you know, what I'm experiencing at any given moment, basically. Someone who I've been reading recently, and I've been kind of going through a lot of his books, is an Icelandic author, and his name is Sjón, just one name. And I think he's an amazing writer, and I've had the chance actually to meet him, and he's a wonderful person too. He's very smart, and because he comes from Iceland, I think a lot of people, maybe in other countries, haven't read a lot of Icelandic literature before, but he's a great place to start. And then I think from there is a world of literature in Iceland. So many great authors from there. So instead of, you know, picking one book or one author, I would encourage people to seek out Icelandic books and literature. And if you get a chance, go to Iceland and read them there, because it's a special place. So.